Bisola. If you're new here, welcome. So today we're going to be talking about tips for surviving in uni. But before I go on, guys, let me give you a side gist. So this is like the third or fourth time I'm trying to film this, and the first two times I tried it, something shy happened about the appearance, and it wasn't nice, and I was like, okay, I had to. But after trying it the third time or the second time, I was like very discouraged. I'm like, nah, I ain't doing this video no more. Like, one video cannot come and be stressing me, shake it. So I'm like, I can't do it. I was actually discouraged. And then when I was just sitting down, being sad and everything, and I just had my spirits. This video is for somebody, and the devil would have the person listen to it. So I was like, devil, this joke is on you. I'm doing it again. Like, I don't mind how many times I try it, I'm still gonna do it. So yeah, that's it. Alright guys, so on today's video, like I said earlier, we're talking about tips for surviving in uni, and I'm gonna be telling you things that have worked for me and are still working for me. So the very first is, you need God. God is an important person in our lives. He wants to be involved in every area of our lives, and so we cannot afford to leave him out of any, as in any area. Like, he gives us the Holy Spirit as our advantage, and so even in your academics, I mean, why would you want to pass, or why would you want to go through a phase in the most difficult form when you can always have it easily? I'm not saying that being in school or being in uni is easy, but I'm saying that, like, with the help of the Holy Spirit, it's much more easier. And so you need to know God, serve him, and understand that you're not serving God because of what you tend to gain from him. You're not serving him because of, oh, what I will receive when I serve him, or what I will get if I love and serve him. No, but you're serving him because of who he is. You have an understanding of the God that you're serving, and so you want to involve him in every area of your life. You want to involve him in your academics, you want to involve him in everything, and so it makes the journey easier, it makes the ride less stressful. And so you want to involve God in everything you do. So God is important. God helped me in my schooling. He made the impossible possible, and so I'm sure, I know that he can do it for you. You have the Holy Spirit as your advantage. You making him involved, it gives you, like, he tells you to the littlest, to the tiniest bit of it, he tells you, just like, get him involved in that life. You want to involve him in your academics, you want him to be a part of it. So you've got to ask him, Holy Spirit, where should I read? Holy Spirit, what should I wear to class? Should I prepare for this test? It gives you an heads up when you're having a pop quiz, safe. That's how good it is. It gives you direction when you're studying. That's how beautiful it is to have him. So I don't know, but I'm sure you want to involve God in your studies, you want to involve him in your academics, you want to involve him in every phase of your life. Now the next thing is making good friends. Now you need good people, you need good support system to actually enjoy or to survive in uni. Trust me, and being in an environment for 4, 5, 6 how long, yes, it's stressful, and you know, it's not easy. We cannot be isolated, you can't do it on your own, so you need support system, people that will give you ginger, people that will gist with you, people that you can study with, people that you can pray with, people that would shall be there to motivate you, to give you morals. You know, you need friends that will be all around, like people that can just make you laugh when you've had a stressful day, people that would, you know, just be there for you. You need to have friends that understand you, that value the same things you value. It helps you to stay on track. It helps you not to be distracted. It helps you to keep yourself in check. So in case you're trying to do something that, oh, you would usually not do, but because of a situation you want to do, you have people who can actually put you in check that, nah, you are not going to do that. No, you're not supposed to be doing that. And it makes it more interesting and less burdensome. Another thing is, you need to engage in extracurricular activities. Yes, it's not only just like academics you're going to school for. Like, school is not just there for you to just go and collect your certificate. No, it's not just there for you to just build your intellectuals. No, you need to build yourself morally, mentally, physically, in all spheres. And so engage in extracurricular activities. If you have to, like, go to the gym, register in the gym, attend programs, volunteer, get empowered, you know, just do stuff that will build you, build your capacity. engaging in extracurricular activities can actually even be a form of relaxing. So you want to chill, you want to relax, take a break, and not just like burnout or wear out or the frustration and school stress. Yeah. Another thing is you need to consult people who are ahead of you. Yeah, you need to make findings, you need to do your findings. I remember when I got into school in 100 level, I felt like, okay, if I just read my books, I mean, I'll study hard and of course I'll pass. After my 100 level first semester results came out, I'm like, but I tried, like I read my books and all. And then I realized that, okay, I probably haven't been doing it the right way. And so, you know, we had like people, our seniors, if you allow me to call them so, who would come around to speak to us and stuff like that. So, how's this lecturer like? What do they want? What would they like? You know, you have to understand your lecturers. It's not actually always about reading. It's understanding that, okay, if it is lecturer, so, this is what he wants. This is how he wants you to answer his question. So, it's not just all about reading or all about studying. And it's about understanding how you should put your questions and how you should put your answers right to get your desired mark. Another thing is managing your finances. You actually need to manage your finances. If you're actually fortunate enough to have parents who are loading you, who give you pocket money every month or allowances every month, and aunties and uncles are always, you know, giving you money as well, it will be wise for you to save. So some seasons are gonna come when these things are not going to be available. And it's not a curse. It's not like, oh, they're going to go poor or something. No. But then there will be seasons that these things will not just show forth. Even sometimes, self, your savings can actually help you in urgent needs, like in emergency needs. For instance, you need to do an assignment or you need to get an handout. And then you call your parents, daddy, oh, I need to buy this, I need to buy that. Or your sponsors, that you need to get some things done. And then they're like, oh, I cannot currently afford it now. Maybe next week or next 2 weeks before I see you. And then you know that you need it urgently. If you don't have savings, you don't have anything to bank on. You'll probably be stranded. And so you need to like, oh, okay, let me lend from my savings. And then, you know, when they return the money, you can always keep it back there. So savings actually save you from being stranded. Yeah. Another thing is, if you can also monetize your skills, I mean, you're a photographer, you're a caterer, you're a fashion designer, make good use of the skills that you've learned, make money out of it. I mean, it will help you to actually save, it will help you to have enough funds, and you know, you will not be stranded and you'll be able to sustain yourself while you're in school. Another thing is making a to-do list. Making a to-do list actually helps you to be accountable and it helps you to do what you want to do, when you want to do it, and how you want to do it. Yeah, for me, making a to-do list actually helps me to be accountable and then not just be doing things wrongly or just, you know, be too confused about what to do. So a to-do list will actually help you to put your plans and your progress in check. Okay, I want to study so and so from so time. You can be that detailed. I want to go and meet so for my book. I want to go and do this. I need to read. You can be that detailed in your to-do list. Doesn't have to be too serious. For me, I write every single thing. Once I have a to-do list, I mean, I don't want to have a clumsy weekend. So I might just forget, oh, I said I want to do this. So once I remember during the week, I take my pen and paper, I'm writing it down. To-do list. I'm doing this, I'm washing my clothes, I'm going to this person, I'm reading my books, I'm doing this. And then there's plan, there's timing. And so at the end of the day, I feel very fulfilled when I come back to my to-do list and I'm ticking it like, okay, I did this. Yeah, it makes you really fulfilling. So you can make a to-do list. It keeps you accountable and it keeps you focused as well. Another thing is find time to relax. In the midst of all the stress, in the midst of all the frustrations that comes with schooling and everything, you need to find time to relax, you need to find time to chill out, you need to find time to take a break. Like, just take time to relax. For me, you're relaxing could be watching a movie, you're relaxing could be going to your friend's place to just cool your brain. Movie, you know, you just set out that time, create that time for yourself. You have to just be so tight, uptight on yourself and be, you know, everything. I came to school to study, so I must read my books. Yes, you must study, you must read very hard, you must study well. But then, take a break. Jiget, live, laugh, be happy. Yeah, that's it. So, with that, I've come to the end of this video and I hope that you've been able to learn a thing or two, and I know that you put into practice. Thank you very much for watching. I love you and Jesus loves you more. See you next time. Bye guys.